telling her about my boyfriend, Kareem. I'm telling her how deeply in love I am with this guy. I'm just telling her, like, you know, he's not perfect, but he's perfect for me. I'm telling her all of this, and she's just there like, Theo, I'm so happy for you. I'm so happy for you. Meanwhile, she's screwing my man. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. As you can tell from the title, I'll be telling a story time on how my ex-boyfriend, boyfriend at the time, cheated on me. So, this story time is not recent. However, I am currently single, for everyone that doesn't know. I will tell story time on that in the future. But for now, that is not what this story time is about. So, this story time takes place, I think I was 20. Maybe a year younger, I don't really remember. No, I'm lying, because I was fresh out of high school, so I had to be 18 or 17. Yeah, and I was turning 18, yes. So this story time, it's just, it hurts my feelings every time I talk about it, because I was really bamboozled by two people I really cared for, sadly. So it starts like this. My birthday, every year, I go really hard. I start to plan out things, how I see it. And this year, I was like, you know what? I just want to do a dinner party. That's really what I want to do. So I begin to start up my my plans and my list and who I'm going to invite. Me, for one, I don't really have that large group of friends. I do, but in a sense, like, not everybody clicks and hangs out with each other. And they're not all my, like, best friends, go-tos, whatever. So for the dinner party, I wanted like a crowd. So I was kind of inviting people that, you know, that didn't really need to be there, but I just wanted to make a crowd. So I was talking to one of my friends and I was like, hey, we'll call her Star. So I was like, hey Star, I'm trying to plan my dinner party. Like, I'm gonna go over my list with you. Let me know all the names sound good. So I said all the names, and then I said this one particular name, I'll call her Crystal. So she goes, why are you inviting Crystal? And I'm like, well, we are kind of cool in school. Mind you, just after school, so, well, the end of high school, whatever, it's the summertime. So I'm like, we are kind of cool. We hang out all the time. We're always telling jokes. She tells me her personal business, like TMI, all the time. So I'm like, why not? She goes, okay, like, chuckle. And I'm just like, what is that about? So now, I kind of brushed it off, but it just was still, like, bothering me a little bit. I didn't say anything about it. Now, I probably started planning in June, mid-June, and my birthday is the 18th. My birthday ended up coming, no. So yeah, I started planning mid-June, and maybe by after my birthday now. My birthday has passed, and I eventually did not invite the girl because my friend Star was like, no. And at the time, I was like, you know, you're my good friend at the time. Like, you wouldn't have steered me wrong, so I just didn't invite her. And everything went well. I don't think I ended up having a dinner party, but whatever. My friend Star now, she was like, hey, all of my friends are about to come to my house for, like, not a sleepover, but, like, we get to our house about 8 p.m. and we're, like, in our casual clothes and we listen to music, drinks, what do you call that? Like, a hangout, and we probably leave by, like, 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. So I get there, we're drinking, we're dancing, and everything is going good. So, mind you, this is her friends that I'm hanging out with. Her as a star friend I'm hanging out with, and I'm only Star's friend, so basically I don't have nobody there to be with but Star. But of course I'm doing my own thing. So whole time we're there, it's a vibe, everything's going good. Whew, my chest is like literally pounding telling this story because it's so freaking embarrassing. And And I don't want you guys to judge her, because at the time, I didn't judge her. But like, every time I tell a story to people, people are like, oh my gosh, she's such a fucked up friend. But you guys let me know down below what you guys consider. She is still a friend of my life, but like, we're not as close as we used to. We're not as close as we used to be because she moved, but you guys let me know how I should move. Well, I'm her friend now, so I forgave her, but you know, if you were in the same position, how would you guys react? So we're all vibing and whatnot, and she's like, oh, let's go around and tell stories or something like that. I can't remember what it was. Long story short, everybody spoke and told a little story, whatever. Then the room got silent and everybody started to look at me, and I'm just like, back then I was even more shyer than I am now. So I'm just like, my hands started getting clammy. I'm like, what is going on? So Star goes, if you guys had a friend and you knew that their man was cheating on them with another friend, what would you do? And everybody's just staring at me. It's not like a question that was said where, oh my God, who is she talking about? Everybody already knew the tea before me. So I'm just like, what? So she goes, Theo, I love you so much, but you know, Crystal's also my friend, so I didn't wanna get in between, but like, me and you has grown even closer since the incident, so I just felt the need, like I have to tell you. And all the girls around me is not, like their facial reaction is kinda like, they know already, but they wanna see my reaction to it. So I'm like, okay, like what happened? Now I'm getting tight, but like shy tight, like. So they're like, Theo, Crystal is sleeping with Kareem. And I kind of like chuckled. So now I'm gonna rewind a little bit, which I should have told you guys this already, but rewind a little bit. So, me and Kareem, we didn't live together, but I was basically always at his house. And there was this one time a girl texted his phone, and me and him didn't really look into each other's phones, but every now and then I would just look, and I seen the girl named Crystal. And obviously that's not her real name, but this girl's name, her actual name, is a name that you don't come across often, especially in Brooklyn. So when I seen it, I was like, who's this? Is that my Crystal? He goes, yeah. No. He said no. So I'm like, oh, no. He said yes. He said, I was like, is that my Crystal? Like, the conversation was very, like, bland. Nothing too suspicious, but I just knew, like, if I was friends with my friend's boyfriend, there would have been a conversation between the both of us. So that was kind of weird for me, but I'm very passive. I'm very like, everything's gonna come to me when it needs to come to me. So I didn't really go investigate it as I should have. But I just left it as that. Like, he was like, oh, she's just a B-I-T-C-H, that be like in the neighborhood, you know, basically calling her like a water boy slash slut. Like, his words were very broad, but within those two things, like, I don't know if she was somebody's slut or like water boy for them, because he's hanging out like in somebody's whatever. So I'm like, okay. So once they told me that they were having sex with each other, I just flashed back to that moment, and I'm just like, the signs were in my face the entire time, and I just was completely oblivious to it all, because I just felt like she was my friend. Like, why would she do that to me? So they're like, yeah. Now everybody's giving their own, like, all the girls. Okay, so I didn't tell you how much girls. Probably was like 8 girls, including me. So the seven girls are like, yeah. She was like, you're a man tall and skinny. Oh, she doesn't understand why you're modeling. You're not that cute. And just mad shady stuff. Like, this girl would literally compliment my looks all the time in school. Compliment, like, how good I look. So all this was alarming. I was just like, wow, like, are you guys serious? And at the time, Uber wasn't a thing. And, like, he had told me, like, oh, when you're done with your friends, I'll get you an Uber home. So from that point, I kind of just got quiet because, one, I was humiliated by a girl that I did not really know. I was my friend's friend. And then I was just like, am I happy that my friend Star told me? Or am I mad at her that she let it happen for so long? Because if I'm not mistaken, she said that they're not doing anything anymore, though. Like, this happened, like, about a month ago. So, like, I was just, like, very confused. So I sat there for a little bit, and I'm like, Theo, don't be sad. Like, you're too cute. If you want, I'll be here up for you, blah, blah, blah. And I'm just, like, just really sad, like, nothing to say. So I called him, and I was like, hey, I'm ready to come home, go by his house, whatever. So he called my Uber for me. So I get there. I get there and he's playing video games. I sit on his bed and my heart is like pounding out of my chest. Like, it's just, whew, can't breathe. So I sit up on the bed and I'm like, so you're fucking Crystal? And his back is turned to me because he's playing a video game, whatever. And he chuckles. And that just, like, my heart just fell into my stomach. Like, whew, I was just like, what? And he goes, I mean, that was a long time ago. A long time ago when? Within the time that we were dating, like, what? And was just not giving me the energy that I needed. Like, he was not answering the questions for me. And at that point, I was just like, I need to go home. Like, I need to go home because he doesn't care and he's not apologetic about it. And ladies, we're not accepting none of that, okay? That was the last time a man cheated on me, okay? We're not accepting none of that. Because I look back and I just am ashamed. Because even after the situation, I stayed, like, do not. So, I don't know what I wanted out of him, because even, wow, my throat is dry. I don't know what reaction I wanted out of him, because at that point, I should have left. Like, I have a home to go to. I have my own room, you know. I should have just left home. But no. He has, like, a bathroom attached to his room. So I was like, you know what? Maybe if I go sit in his bathroom, he'll come and chase me and tell me to come lay in the bed. Bitch. I went to the bathroom, and I just, like, sat on the floor. And I took a towel and I just, like, rested my head. And, like, you know, some things, like, you just naturally cry about. Like, my body was sad, but it wasn't, like, crying sad. It was just more so, like, I'm sad, but you can move on, like, whatever. I forced myself to cry. As I was saying, I forced myself to cry. Yes. Sorry, guys, my camera died. But as I was saying, I forced myself to cry, and that just showed you, like, your body knows, ladies. Your body knows. But I just was, like, so desperately to make things work between us. But long story short, I ended up falling asleep. And literally, I woke up by the sun hitting me in my face from the window. And I'm just like, this nigga really made me sleep on the bathroom floor. He didn't make me, but he let me, like. And at that point, I should have left. I should have truly left, but I didn't. So I gotta tell you too, when I told you, like, I flashed back to a certain point when she told me, maybe 3 weeks prior, I was working at the mall, Kings Plaza, if you guys know of that mall, based in Brooklyn. I was working there, and she also was working at a different store in the mall. And she came to me, and she's like, hey, let's do lunch. And I'm like, okay, cool. I think it was at, like, Severo. I don't remember where we had lunch at, but we were just talking, and she was telling me about her current boyfriend at the time. And this is Crystal. Crystal's telling me about her current boyfriend. She's telling me that her boyfriend's in jail, and she's holding him down, and she loves him, this, that, and the third. She can't wait for him to come out. And I'm telling her about my boyfriend, Kareem. I'm telling her how deeply in love I am with this guy. I'm just telling her, like, you know, he's not perfect, but he's perfect for me. I'm telling her all of this, and she's just there like, Theo, I'm so happy for you. I'm so happy for you. Meanwhile, she's screwing my man. And you know what? The sad part about it is, this girl, she was just one of those girls that I accepted her lifestyle. If anything, I was more so like learning from her in a sense, because she used to be in high school just doing a whole lot of shit. If I ever wanted a question about anything sexual, she had the answers to it. And I never judged her as a slut. I just was like, you know, she is who she is. But for her to turn around and do that to me, it was just like, I can't trust females. But, okay, moving on with the story. I stayed with him. We spoke about it. Very brief. Like, he just said it happened a long time ago. It wasn't even an apology. It was just like, it happened a long time ago. And I was just like, wow. But anyways, I let it go. My friend Star also told me to let it go because it's not currently happening anymore. And yeah, I sound like a dumb bitch right now, just telling the story. I sound crazy, but this is my past, and this is what happened to me. And I'm sharing the story so that you guys can remember my mistakes and know that it's not okay. Move on. It's okay to be alone. It's okay to be by yourself. And I wish I had somebody telling me that. But even if I did, I wouldn't listen. Everything is trial and error. But yeah, at the time I was popular on Facebook. If I could find it on Facebook, I'll show the post, whatever. But basically, I commented something like, she is the first one. Crystal is the first one to comment because everything happened and I never confronted her because I'm a Cancer. Let's not say I'm a Cancer. I'm Theodora and I do not like confrontation. Like, we're not in the same school no more, so it's just like, I'm never going to see you again. I don't work in a mall no more, so it's like, I'm never going to see you again. So, she comments under my post, and she goes, you should do blank hair. So, the notification pops up on my phone, and I'm just like, my hands have to get clammy, like, I need to let this girl know, because I just let social people think that I'm like, oblivious to certain things, but I feel like with this situation, I had to let her know that I knew. So I wrote her something like, bitch, don't worry about my hair, something about fucking my man, like something stupid. So I said something like that, and she goes, what? And then she had like this little white girl that used to hang out with her. I'm probably saying too much. If you guys from Flatbush, I know what I'm talking about because it was just two peas in a pod. But, they came attacking me under my own post, like, oh, go check your man, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, you're right, I did check my man, or whatever. I shouldn't have even been with him, but you guys are both, quote unquote, my friends. Like, why wouldn't you even, like, why would you even do that? So we went back and forth a little bit, whatever, and then Kareem calls me. Yo, stop all that. You're not even like that. What do you mean you're gonna fight her? Delete all that post. And I'm just like, you really defending this girl? And you're not like, and he just kind of hung up and was like, I'm staying out of it. But it was just like, that just showed me again, like, to leave the situation. Because, like, you caused this and now you're telling me to back off and just stay in my place and not express myself. So, at the end of it all, me and her never see each other again. Me and her, her best friend, I actually forgot her name, so whatever, but she was Caucasian. I seen her one time after the event, years later, and she kind of like smirked at me. Not like a smirk, like, it was like a smirk, like she was happy to see me almost. But I still remember what she did to me, what her and her friend did to me, so I was kind of like, okay. But the moral of the story is just, ladies, do not tolerate anything. Like, move on in that situation. Because a lot of us, we will stick to something and we will age. Like, you just start to look really old because you're dealing with so much stress. And you don't need that. Don't need that at all. Throw the guy away. Keep pushing. Like, secure yourself. Like, no, I was just too concerned about that relationship. I don't know why. And to this day, like, we don't see eye to eye. So, yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed my story time. I have a lot more stories to tell. This story was kind of long and whatever, but it's just something I felt like I needed to share. So I hope you guys enjoy. And if you got to the end, I love you so, so much. It is Monday night. Hopefully I can get this done and edit it tonight. So thanks, friends.